Hey, what's up, man? You seen Boy?
Yeah. You know where he's at right now, right?
Nah.
I'll show you. He is right next door now. He moved from his place.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
He's been here for a few weeks already.
Is he in there now, or?
Yeah, I'm just gonna knock on his door.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Boy. It's Michael. Mike, I got one of my friends here wondering
if I want to set the door up. I'm pretty fresh now, so.
So, yeah, boy, my friend Peter here.
Hi, Peter, how you doing?
Hi, Lee.
Okay, come in.
Yeah.
First started my business in 2001. I was on La Cienega right here in near Olympic, and he was working in the back for a guy, Red Lefkowitz. He does like t-shirt graphics. He was like the artist that did the silk screening. You know what silk screening is? So you do t-shirts. First they have to draw it out on the paper, and then it goes through a process. So Boy did all of that like for that guy from start to finish. So I knew him there for like, I was there for about 4 or 5 years. Then I moved my business somewhere else, down La Cienega by 18. And it didn't go for me well. And I came down here like 2007. And Boy came to me and he was telling me I was having, you know, money problems. And he lent out like a lot of money to people and all this. And he couldn't afford paying his rent. So I helped him out a little bit here and there with some food and some, you know, couple bucks here and there, nothing major. And up until like a few months ago, he got evicted out of his place because the people that his friends that he lent them like a lot large amounts of money, they never paid him back. So what happened was he ended up, he needed a place like last minute, and I didn't know what to do. He couldn't stay at my place because it was really small, and my landlord only lets like one person. So I came up with an idea. We had a storage room over here where he could stay temporarily until he finds a place. And now he's been in there for about, I'd say it's been like 2 months, and he's been doing like small portraits for people that just passed by, and they discover him and they see that, you know, he has some small paintings here and there. So he's actually started like to meet people here, and you know, like people like his work.
I would not go to a hair club for men. I would not get Botox in my lip or my face. I would not pump myself up with steroids. And you know, what you see is what you freaking get. And I'm not ashamed of a bit of it. I hope you caught that. I don't know if you did or not. Just turn the damn thing on, man, when you want to. It's fine with me. Here's to all you budding artists and craftsmen who have ever faced the entire blank area of surface on a canvas or something and didn't know what the hell to do with it. We'll do something different. Doesn't always work. Well, I'll tell you what, I only went part way through. What these did, they magnified about 5,000 times, and will make an excellent texture.
What are you doing for money?
Most recently, I begged my mom to be able to send me a couple hundred dollars. And that's about the only thing that's keeping me solvent at this point. Other than that, like I said, I try to look on the positive side about the thing. I'm not insane. I'm relatively sane. I'm in relatively good health for a 55-year-old person. And actually, I'm supposed to have an appointment with Social Security next month to have them check out my kidneys because I had this ailment since I was about 13 or 14 called glomerular nephritis, which is like a nerve disorder in the kidneys. And if I get really exerted and tired out, I'll actually bleed out of my kidneys. I'll eliminate blood. And I need to have some doctors look at me. And I need, you know, and I have about over $160 put in the Social Security system for the number of years I worked. And incidentally, while we're talking about it, the EDD papers that I have during the 20 years I worked for Red shows that he didn't put a single fucking penny of unemployment insurance in the account while I worked for him, which is a federal offense. I hope you're watching this, Red.